Right, that's Fuzz. He's the guy who got us our in initially. That's the Echo Arena behind us. Connor's behind the camera. And in a minute we're gonna go in there and imagine how embarrassing it'd be if you turn around and go, sorry, go away. I'll just have to go home and pretend we're actually live.
We'll go to Wembley and watch one of their white collar ones there instead.
Give them some coverage. Go watch Mary instead. Like, go watch Mary fighting. No, I'll have to go home and like film our telly's really, really close up. But all being well, we'll be allowed in and we can film it in super HD, 4K, whatever technology has just been invented in the last 10 minutes. So, right, until later on. Arena. I feel like Wayne out of Wayne's World. We're going to walk around and go, hey, we've got these. Just to prove there's Connors. Here we go, we're all set up. People are starting to come in. It's not a sellout, which is disappointing, but you can see why not. And at some point, we're going to head down that way, take our seats, take our notes, film whatever footage we're allowed to film, and cover as much as we can for you here, live or stock footage for House of Scouts TV. Okay. So, we can just grab a couple of minutes with you if that's
right.
Okay. Right, so I've got the legendary voice of boxing, Jim Watt here. You've seen many a show here in Liverpool, haven't you, down the years?
Yeah, I've got a lot of good fighters from Liverpool here. Coming from Glasgow, I'm always made welcome in Liverpool. We're kind of a similar people to the Glaswegians and the Liverpudlians, and I'm always pleased to come down here.
Fantastic. Well, it's good to have you here yet again. What are you looking forward to most about the main card tonight?
Well, I mean, since big Callum turned pro, you know, we thought he was a little bit special the first time we saw him. And he's just it's been a steady rise. I'm not surprised that his chances have come so early.
Yeah.
You know, I think he's good enough now to beat some of the big names. So yeah. I'm looking for him to do a job tonight.
Yeah, of course. The fielding with Ross White, I mean, Eddie was saying in the press conference at the weigh-in, it's kind of almost not quite a last chance saloon for one of them, but near as.
Last chance is a little bit strong, but it's an important fight. But I'm glad they brought Big Rocky back in a proper fight. I mean, if you bring him back in a little six-rounder or something, you know, they start asking themselves questions. Why? What was wrong? Well, you know, I've lost a fight. It's not the end of the world. Yeah. So I'm glad that they brought him back at a good level. It's a fight that means something. It's a fight, you know, you can move on from.
Yeah, of course, and Cardle Dodd too. I was at home remembering your dulcet excited tones, I should say.
That was a terrific fight the last time. I think Scotty Cardle, I think he underestimated Dodd quite a bit the last time. He started recklessly, got himself cut straight away. So I think, of the two, Cardle's the one who can improve on last performance. I don't know that Dodd can, but, I mean, he's beaten Gary Buckland.
Yeah.
He's took Cardle to the wire, who knows?
Yeah. Last question I want to ask, apologies for my own memory. You fought in Liverpool yourself, I mean...
No, I didn't fight in Liverpool.
Didn't you fight in Liverpool? No. Would you have loved to, though?
No, I wasn't good enough to fight in Liverpool.
Yeah. Would you have liked to, though?
Yeah, of course I would. Yeah. Of course I would. But no, I mean, when I was doing my stuff, there was no top lightweights in Liverpool at that time. So I boxed in Manchester, Leeds, and probably everywhere else. It just didn't have a lightweight back then.
Listen, Jim, thank you very much for your time. Appreciate it. Legendary. Thank you very much.
There we go. They've got wristbands. Why don't we have wristbands?
Sorry, I'm just nabbing around as we go. Because we've got our esteemed colleagues from BTV sat next to us covering the show as well. So, I don't know if Lisa wants to say hello live. Can I say hello live to everyone on
hello,
House of Scouts TV?
Hi, House of Scouts TV. Enjoy BTV. The boxing. We're BTV. Team Masher.
Team Masher, yeah.
We're team sat on the fence for that one at the moment.
Come on!
House of Scouts TV. Mardy's in the ring. I was pretty close to Callum Smith as he walked through. He didn't just walk through, he stormed through. This is going to be over short and sweet. Scanner's going to be on the last bus back to the north end. I'm going to be putting left foot in front of right to the south end. This is game over. It's going to be over short, sweet. I'm going to stay inside the opening three rounds, and I'll be absolutely honest about that. I don't think we're seeing three rounds out. Callum just marched into that ring. He wants it done. He wants it out the way. He wants to get to that after show party, and he deserves it. So come on, Mundo.
Punching out of the blue distance, the perfect record of 14 KOs, is the undefeated British Super Bowl World Champion, the undefeated WBC International Champion, and the reigning and defending WBC Silver Super Middleweight Champion.
Looking at the next WBC champion of the world, Callum Mundo Smith. So my reaction, all that's on this, isn't it? Right, you know what? I actually don't care. Right. And there's a guy behind the camera I'm gonna say thank you to in Scone. We fucking hustled this. Right, and we did back in November. We chatted about doing a little bit of a hustle, see what we could pull. We sent an email to Matthew, he turned around and went, yeah, come down, be part of the family. Be a part of the family for the Smithfield and fight for the press conference and the weigh-in. We hustled a little bit more. We're still here tonight with D's round our necks. That does say press the right way up. Do you know what I mean? So just proves two lads from Liverpool went out special. Do you know what I mean? Just gonna hide behind the camera. I say all the time I'm humbled to do this. And I'm hoping you guys will enjoy this tonight. Not even a tenth as much as I have, because this has been an absolute fucking ball. Honestly, humbled, love being House of Scouts. Ladies
and gentlemen, timekeeper at the bell, Barry Pinder, records a time of 1 minute and 41 seconds of the first round. Therefore, Mardy is in no position to continue. And therefore, your winner. And the new
what a week. I've got to give massive props to Scone. Thank you very much for everything. Group of Bay TV who plugged our show.
Give them a woo. Give Katie a woo.
Woo! what can you say? Our show June 24th. You all know when that is. So, unless, you know. But this has just been something else.